Okay, well now, go ahead and move into financial, get some black.
The first thing that I have in the, under the finance tab, I did this last year, is definition. In the back of your budget book, there is a huge glossary, and what I've done is taken this and condensed it down to things that you probably hear more often, just to kind of give you something to reference back to. But then we'll move, as we move into the report, if you recall the last several retreats, what I've done is compare where we are at the 6 month point this year compared to the prior year. And I added something to it this year just to see where we have come. There's also a column in there for where we were in 2010. What you will notice as we go through that, of course, there were some departments that are no longer there. There may have been a couple that have been added since then, but there was a lot of outside agency funding and things like that as well. But you can see the differences, again, between this year and where we were this year and last year, and also where we were in 2010. And again, as of our prior years, this is not every fund, but these are all the funds that have the human element to them. I didn't include things like the SPLOST or grants that are things that are kind of ins and outs. But the first fund we have here is the general fund. And the very first line that you have there under property taxes is your property tax. And if you'll notice where we are this year compared to last year, just under $13 million, where we were at $20 million last year. And of course, that's because of the delay in property tax. And there'll be a slide, there'll be a page on that a little bit later where I'll talk more about that and where we are. But compared to 2010, we were at $17 million. Of course, we've had some changes in the military growth and that, a little bit of growth in the digest. If you look, most everything else is kind of in line. Your local option sales tax is down from where it was last year. And we've seen, Harrison's going to talk more about sales tax in a little bit, but we've seen those declines. And when we do see a little bit of growth, it usually goes right back down. So there's really not any kind of pattern on the local option sales tax. But your total taxes this year compared to last year, you're at 42.86%, or $19 million. Compared to this time last year, $27.2 million, or 61.36%. Your licenses and expenditures are down from last year. These are the MEDES for the stormwater fees. So whatever is comes in as a revenue, they will not expend any more than that. So that's kind of a wash. Under your intergovernmental accounts, indigent defense, we are getting a little bit more funds in that. Well, actually, last year there was a issue with the state and how they were sending that money in. So if you see the probation line there, from last year was $65,000. They have separated those back into indigent defense and probation. So those two lines, you have to kind of compare both of those to that probation line from last year. If you scroll down just a little bit, Brooks County ankle monitoring last year, Brooks County decided to participate in that program. They're no longer participating. So that revenue went away. We are a little bit ahead of where we were last year on prisoner housing, which is good. Both for Valdosta and for all the other governments. And those are, the city of Valdosta is ahead of where it was in 2010. But if you look at the difference in where the other governments were in 2010 compared to where they are now, so we still are down overall on our prisoner housing fees. $769,800, compared to $606,500. Under your charges for service, Board of Elections, you'll be up just because of the activity in this year. You have more elections, you'll have qualifying, you'll have municipal elections that are reimbursed. Clerk of Court, ahead of where it was this time last year, but a good bit behind where it was in 2010. We've talked about the fines and the court fees and all of those being down from where they have been historically. Magistrate Court actually is pretty much in line. Most of these are pretty much in line. You'll see some differences in the Sheriff's Department fees. The big one that we talked about last year during the budget was the fingerprinting, because that had dropped significantly last year. Those are going back up, so we're actually way ahead of where we anticipated, because they have started doing those again.
$5,340% increase.
$5,340% of what you budgeted, so.
Yeah.
So far. It is. Credit card fees, the county did not charge, we did not accept credit cards back in 2010. We started doing that. And what you'll see on our credit card fees, those increase every year, but so do the expenditures for that. So, but we are so far staying ahead of the expenditures by charging the $2 fee that we charge. Evidence tapes, there's another example of one. We were at $5,450 this time in 2010. We are not collecting unless it is a citizen that comes in and gets those. So it's usually $100 a year, maybe. Total charges for service, $711,000 compared to $624,000 last year. Again, 2010, we were at 746. Fines and forfeitures. Your state court fines are ahead of where they were this time last year. Those do seem to be coming in a little bit better than they were last year. But again, they're below where they were in 2010. And I have a slide on fines that will be coming up, or pages on fines. And you can see the trend on what has been happening on fines since early on back to 2000. Total fines this year, $597,000 compared to $389,000 last year. Again, in 2010, we were at $765,000 this time. Investment income, that fluctuates from year to year. We are a little bit down this year from where we were last year. Under the miscellaneous, the resource officer, we don't get the contract on that. We just receive the checks from the school system twice a year, and that's kind of, we just have to use the current year to kind of judge where we're going to be on that. But you can see that in 2010, we were about $300,000, and they had already paid for the whole year at that time. We're looking at $518 for this year. Then you have your rents in there. We are a little bit ahead of where we were in 2010 on the rents, because we've added a couple of things, some the public health and some.
Let me add one thing. If I'm correct, on the recent back to the recent talks of just a minute. Of course, that amount being up is due to the fact that the school system has also requested an additional resource officer for all the school systems.
That's correct.
But what really wasn't an increase from the county was an increase in actually their request for resource.
Right.
Resource.
Right.
It
was a wash.
Yeah.
So what would grant other than
that is Human Resource Building, the old Administration Building, the Lila Ellis Building.
Does the tax commissioner pay?
The tax commissioner is not paying that.
I noticed we don't have any funding there, but it stopped a long time ago. What was the Battle of the Border?
Battle of the Border was a softball tournament that was here in Lake Park.
We used to have a community development position, and they handled that tournament.
And they brought in a little bit of money, or it just didn't bring any money?
It was a charity.
Okay.
When will that, I mean, if that's no longer, no longer doing that, when will that line actually change?
Well, it actually has disappeared, but when I put the 2010 comparison there, that's the only reason it's there. It's normally never there.
I didn't know that.
Stephanie, why did the other rent, why did our budget double this year? Or did it?
No, it did double. There's not a budget number in there for last year. What you're seeing is where we collected 6 months. So you were at 304 this time last year, and you're at 320 this year. But the budget this year is 648.
Well, that makes sense.
So, and the reason we did the comparison between this year is because everything is not halfway there whenever you look at it. So it's kind of hard to compare unless you're looking at the same time period. Then you have your transfers in for total revenues so far this year, $22,500,000 compared to this time last year, just under $30 million. And again, the 2010, we were at $26,600,000. Again, a lot of that is because of that property tax. Okay, if you look over at your expenditures, again, these are going to compare where you were this year, last year, and in 2010. Most of these are in line. The county attorney is down from where it was last year, and in line with where it was in 2010. Yes, sir.
I guess the obvious question as to why it's down.
There's varying things that can affect that.
Large amount of the cost associated with the tournament is when we're doing local option sales tax negotiations, service delivery negotiations, special purpose. Every time that we have to get into the negotiations between the cities and the county, and it gets to a legal point, then those expenses go up. And yes, it also depends on the amount of lawsuits that we might have and so forth that they're required to defend, not only for the county commissioners, but the sheriff's office, work they did for one of the agencies, the health department.
Board of assessors.
A lot of the board of assessors, there's a library, and so on.
Also, if we do a bond referendum or a refinancing or something like that, and there are bond fees involved, similar to real estate transactions, sometimes the attorney will go ahead and write that check as a part of that, then they bill the county, and then we reimburse. So what you see sometimes is not their hourly amount. It's because those bond fees or something that was wrapped up in a real estate transaction or something was wrapped up in that deal.
Okay. Good morning.
All right, moving on. County manager in line with where he was last year. Significantly below where he was in 2010. Board of Elections, in line with where they were last year, and really in line with where they were in 2010.
primary, it's just because they, that, the risk management.
They absorb that, right.
Any other, outside of that, and it would be the lower.
It's pretty much in line otherwise. They picked up the, all the insurance, liability, casualty. ITS is actually below where they were this time last year. They had, some projects that had lingered from the previous year. They got paid in last year, and that's why they were ahead of where they normally are last year. But they're back in line, and where they should be so far this year. General facilities. General facilities, that is where, that's your postage. Your postage is ahead this year. And it just depends on when they add postage to the machine and what all is going out, as to what, where that falls during the year. But that's where your general county postage and your, general phone lines fall. Tax commissioner, in line with where that number is. Board assessors, facilities maintenance engineer, all these again are in line. Stormwater is a little bit ahead, but again, remember that whatever that revenue was, they're not expending any more than that. And their expenses just came later in the year. They did their mail out later in the year last year. Contingency, we have not paid out as much this year as last year. You recall last year we had the, crime lab budgeted for in contingency. That has been moved into the sheriff's department this year, so we don't have that expense in there. Superior Court, back in line where it normally would be. It was a little bit high last year. Community Corrections, that, is a department that was not in existence in 2010. We have not expended as much this year as in the prior year. But remember, we will also have a position that is added. I think they're advertising, or ready to advertise.
This is the ankle monitoring program. We'll commonly call it. And if y'all recall, last year's budget, we agreed to fund an additional person for half a year,
right,
which will start January 1, and that's the position that they're advertising.
And where's that under?
That's under the Community Corrections.
Personal services and contracts.
Clerk of Court in line. District Attorney is a little bit, ahead dollar-wise, but that was because there was an increase in the District Attorney, for the prior position. District Court Administrator, we pay that all out at one time in July usually. State Court, ahead of where you were last year. And part of that is the new judge. I think it was 2 or 3 months into the year before, that position was filled last year. Solicitor in line, very close to what it was in 2010. Magistrate Court, again in line. Probate Court, a little bit ahead of where it was last year. Juvenile Court, is a good bit ahead of where it was. The representation, the appointed attorneys, are significantly ahead of where they were last year, and that's where the majority of that cost is coming from. look down, Sheriff's Department Administration, this is the, only the administration portion of Sheriff's Department, $868,000 so far this year, compared to $736,000 last year, $677,000 in 2010. Enforcement is a little below where they were last year. Last year they had some large items that came up at the beginning of the year that they asked the county to purchase. There were some ice machines and some scanners. So they had some good-sized capital at the beginning of the year last year, and that's why last year was ahead of this year.
Question, did we gave them two additional personnel for tickets, I mean to process tickets, or have you last year?
Those were added to the performance.
So those?
But
it, did we take it from the sheriff to process it?
He had positions that were not filled, and we took two of those positions that were not three. That were not filled, and we added those to the clerk's office. The discussion was, y'all took people from them. Well, we took slots, but those positions, he still had 10 positions that he could not fill or had not filled. So, I could add three, I could add 23. But if you couldn't fill the 10, you can't fill the 13.
It's a little difficult to understand, but it really, as Mr. Fritchie just said, it doesn't make any sense to add the expense of additional positions if you can't hire those people to fill those positions. So we just took those two positions and moved them over to the clerk. So you didn't lose any people to the positions.
If you funded it otherwise, it would have been reallocated somewhere else. I got
it. Yes, just there.
So it was reflected in his budget, in his admin budget, as a decrease versus a...
I believe the positions are actually in the jail.
That's right.
Because the jail is where there's normally more unfilled positions. And so those positions in the jail were basically frozen, and then they were added to the clerks.
Positions that are funded but can't fill.
Well, as you know, positions of the jail are high turnover positions. It's probably the highest turnover we have at any position in the county because just people. They think they want to get into law enforcement, but they get into that, and pretty soon they're disillusioned and they're looking for something else, or they get an opportunity to go out to be on the road, which is what they really wanted anyway.
Right. That should be where they start. Well, it is law enforcement. So, pretty much do.
It's very similar to state code, you start with regular law.
Also keep in mind that last year the crime lab again was in a contingency. This year it is in the enforcement budget. If you look at the jail this year, $3.8 million compared to 3.7 last year. Compare that to 2.6 in 2010. Lower than they were in the prior year.
the little building, the house, actually, or the office over on Webster Street, remodeled, would be anticipation of moving the coroner's office out of Remington City Hall, which is where they've been located ever since that building was built. We had a request to see if we could get some additional space to relocate the coroner simply because they're outgrowing that office where they're at right now. And so we went ahead and remodeled that building and with the hope that the coroner would agree to move in there. At this time, he has not done that. However, part of that might be to the fact that and we won't know, of course, until the first week in March or second week in March, from the standpoint of whether he's going to seek re-election or not. But speculation is that he is not going to. I'm not answering that question for him. I'm just saying that's kind of speculation. There's some other folks lining up. However, the issue is that he may just say, well, I'm right here again. I'm not going to move now. But we do have a facility ready to relocate the coroners, whatever that change takes place.
So we pay the rent?
That's down. No.
That was a SPLOST project.
Yeah, that's that deal on the street.
You have Public Works, Road Maintenance, Road Construction, and Traffic Light, and they're all pretty much in line. And then what you see after that is your outside agencies. And most of these are in line where they were last year. But if you look at 2010, you can see all the different agencies that we were paying funds out to. Of course, Feed the Elderly. We were giving funds to the Chamber of Commerce in 2010. To the Historical Society, Southside Recreation, Children's Advocacy Center, COLA. And you have Board of Equalization and our transfers out. So if you compare, we're at $21,888,000 this year compared to $21,866,000 last year. 2010, we were at $18,106,000. So at this point in the year, your general fund is $611,000 ahead of expenditures, whereas last year it was $8 million ahead. And again, that's because of that property tax revenue.
You ran these numbers in January, they look a little different.
A little. Still not where they should be, but and you'll see that in a little bit. The next page has your commissary fund, where it was at this point this year versus last year. We are about $8,700 behind revenues at this point this year compared to $21,500 last year.
Can that be reflected due to lower population or just less purchases?
It fluctuates. The commissary sales fluctuate so much. It also depends on those vendor commissions off the sales as well. Jail Operations Fund, we are $130,000 behind revenues so far this year compared to $198,000. But if you look at your expenditures, or look at your revenues in comparison to where they were in 2010, that is again, that fine revenue and the differences in those. And, I mean, you can even see that in your municipal fines. It's not just the fines that come through the county, it's also those municipal fines. So we're behind on that fine revenue again. The expenditures, a lot of those expenditures have shifted to your general fund. that's why your expenditures are a little bit less than they have been historically. Your emergency communications, most of the things that are under intergovernmental there are your public safety radio system revenues. The only one that is not related to public safety radio system is that last line. There are other government 911 charges, and that's what you charge Edwards County for 911 services. And those all, but those revenues cover that public safety radio system expenditure department. If you look at your charges, that's where your phone charges come in. You're at $757,000 this year. If you look at where you were in 2010, you were at $906,000. So we've seen the decline in the landlines mostly. You have a little bit of fluctuation in the wireless, but the landlines, we have consistently seen a decline in those.
Okay, and we have had some discussions on this, and a lot of that decline is the fact that to some degree, for example, students that might be coming to BSU, but yet their phone is assigned in another area, so that drops that. So as that goes up, that's going to fluctuate with that. There also, was there not some discussion in last year's legislators in regards to making an adjustment to that fee charged on cell phones to kind of get that correction made? I don't recall exactly where it ended up and what that issue was, so maybe that's something different.
I don't believe that legislation passed.
We need more. Right, okay.
But you also have the trend of people getting rid of their home telephones and just having cell phones too, yeah. And that's where that landline decline, some of that comes from.
Yeah,
well, almost did that with the cell.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's just it. As landlines typically will continue to decline, then if we don't make an adjustment on the sales side, then you're going to lose some there.
Second quick question. I know we don't have anything there, but in the past, what did we have for investment income? What was that cover?
That had to do with, for years and years, we had a banking agreement with Regions and had all of our accounts where they were interest bearing, and they came in around that time and said we have to start charging some fees on these accounts, and we're going to offset some of your accounts, make them non-interest bearing, and let that offset the fees. So we kind of lost a lot of our interest bearing accounts because of that.
Most people have.
Yeah.
DA and the solicitor are the two who receive funds out of here. We did reduce those. The fine monies are about where they were this time last year, so we are keeping an eye on that. Our total revenues are up just a little bit, so, but the ones that come from the cities are pretty much in line. But I think the clerk of court is a little bit ahead on paying those from where she was last year. The district attorney, you'll see the reduction, and that is the difference, and he took a deduction and also gave a little bit more than his proportion to the solicitor so that they could keep that position.
So, I mean, one time I see we had fund the payment.
We did that. Up until 2010, the Haven was included in that, but because of the decline in the fines, the solicitor and the district attorney talked about it, and they removed the Haven from the funding.
That was the issue. The commission, some commission control in Lowndes County, that decision was made by the district attorney.
That's actually true in all counties, Joe. Those funds are always open.
Well, I know.
I just want to mention.
The Haven has produced letters where the county commissioners have made those decisions. If the DA allows them to do that.
Right.
It's his decision, but if he says, or she says, I'll let the county commissioners decide, then that's fine. But if Harrison's right, it's the decision of the DA here. The county commissioners have never gotten involved in that decision.
Special services, again, this is the unincorporated only revenues, unincorporated only expenditures. You see all the different taxes that go into that, $2.9 million, a little bit ahead of last year. Insurance premium tax increase from what it was last year. Our licenses and permits, our alcohol licenses are a little bit ahead of where they were last year. Of course, we have two or three change on every commission meeting. So. And then your zoning fees are a little bit ahead of where they were last year, this time last year. Over on the expenditure side, again, we broke out facilities maintenance for fire that had not previously been a separate department. You have your South Georgia Regional Commission dues. Fire in line with where it was, or it's a little bit ahead of where it was last year. But down from where it was in 2010, the speed of control, and that had to do, the reason it's less than it was in 2010 had to do with how we did that contract with Dr. Blackmore. The reason you see the airport and tourism authority in this budget is that was when there was the change in hotel motel, and hotel motel was run through this. However, the next year the Department of Audits wanted those moved back into a separate fund. You have the county planner. There's been some changes in that department. That's why there's another person in that department that was not in there in 2010. That was the change in that. Excuse me. And then zoning in line with where it was last year. So far this year, you're $1.4 million ahead on your revenues compared to $1.2 last year. And then you have your water sewer fund. done, and what you'll see at the end of the year is a transfer from SPOST to cover those who receive an offsetting revenue for those. Over on the next page is the property tax collections for 14, 15, and 16 by month. And you can see the delay in some of those tax revenues. Typically, by the end of November, we've collected $15 to $18 million. As of the end of November of 2016, we've collected 3.6, or 2015, we collected 3.6 million. Those are starting to come in, so we're getting closer to where we should be.
Yeah, we're just waiting to approach this out.
The next slide, and Harrison will go over this a little bit more when he talks about sales tax. But this is something we have talked about a couple of times over the past year. The motor vehicles, since the change in the TABT, the blue bar you have there is your motor vehicle ad valorem, which is only going to decline because the only thing you have on there are vehicles that were purchased before the TABT went into place, and that as those decline in value or they're sold, those will decline or disappear. The orange bar is the TABT, which is supposed to offset the difference in motor vehicle ad valorem and sales tax. And again, Harrison will bring this up, but there's been a change in the percentage because of the amount the state anticipates the local governments receiving.
So they looked at it as a total amount that will pay out at the ABT.
Right.
Is that correct?
They're looking at, they have a target amount that the local governments are supposed to receive as a whole. And because that number has exceeded, or the number has exceeded that target, they are reducing the percentage that goes to the local governments and not looking at how each individual government, because some governments have received windfalls, but most governments may be actually losing money.
They're not looking at it as a per government basis, a per county basis. They're looking at all the counties combined. This is what we want to pay out. And if they pay out more than that, then they get it.
Specific counties. Mm-hmm. They're looking at it as a whole, but they're going back to those specific counties
that collect more.
They're going to reduce theirs.
I don't think so. They're reducing everybody's.
They're reducing the whole.
So counties that collected more, the counties that collected more are going to still collect more. The counties that got less are still going to get less. It's not a countywide. It's not. They're going to make Downs County whole.
No.
They're going to make all the counties whole. So if you're getting a bigger part of that pie already, you're still getting a bigger part of it. They cut the whole rate across for every.
Correct.
For every county.
Smaller pies.
That's right.
If you're getting more, you're still getting more, and if you're getting less, you're still getting less.
Right.
They want their number to be based, I guess, off of whatever number they figured in 2012, and that's kind of where the counties are stuck. It's as a total, that 2012 number, and so if your TABT goes way up next year, you're going to cut it back to, and we're still going to get it from the kind of average 2012 as a 159 counties combined.
I asked our delegation for an explanation. It's us looking at it right now. Basically, it's going to be a net decrease, what it appears to be, for us. And so trying to get a handle on that, I asked the question of them if they were going to do some research, and they still are. Representative Powell is the one that is working on this state level, and so he is recognized, apparently he's got some other calls on this, and they are supposed to be putting that together, getting their getting their information in so that they could make a decision of what adjustments, if any, could be made. I'm kind of waiting on that. As soon as I get it, I'll share it with you.
What's roll all this on? Going from the birthday tax to what's roll all this?
I can't tell you, I don't live in a mile.
The general city.
Yes, the general city.
So the state benefits more than?
This was a method they were, they came up with as a funding mechanism for other items.
They pass it due to that, their birthday tax. And then they turn around and collect the money on the sales used to buy that. Used to when Scotty sold the corner market, the tax paid on that. Now when Scotty sells the corner market, it is tax paid on that. So that's where they make the difference in losing the birthday tax.
You want to get out of it and get paid back.
And people were complaining about the annual ad valorem, so now those taxes just get rolled into your finance and then your finance your car. So you go to get your tag and you're paying $30 or $40 where it might have been $300 or $400 or more until that started to depreciate.
Tag's $18, the tax is $1,800.
But I think also, if I'm understanding right, it's part of it was, and it may adjust itself, but what I want to know is that they've adjusted that interest down, will they also adjust that interest back up if those numbers were to decline the TABT?
There is supposed to be an annual calendar year review, and that's what this adjustment requires.
Okay.
Because of a calendar year to look back.
Just reading and listening to what I hear, everything that I hear about the automobile industry is that they had an exceptional year across the board last year. So that's part of the reason why those numbers were up. Now, if that kind of begins to level out and get back to where it normally would be, then that revenue is going to be reduced. And so this one is trying to clarify the fact that this number will be adjusted back.
Got a 10-year lifespan, the last county is down to 940-some thousand people on the digest. Yeah. I mean, they're falling off dramatically.
Yeah, I guess they're anticipating at that point in time, the lifetime of the older vehicles, they will pretty well be out.
But they will wipe them off the books. Yeah. So Judge Elliott's truck will finally go. He has a very old truck.
I do have two charts combined on this one. So if you see the gray line there, that is your sales tax, and you have to use the axis on the right-hand side for that one because the scale is different. But I wanted to show the decline in the sales tax as well. And I'm not sure if Mark mentioned it or not, there was a, well, I think it's in his audit report, that there was an increase in the local option sales tax last year. But if you look at that, where that gray line is, it's not where it was 2 years ago, or especially 3 years ago. The next page is your fine revenue history. The blue is the state court. The red is the superior court. And I added trend lines on that. So there is something, there has been some little fluctuations, and it has come back up a little, but it's been declining again the last 4 years. But if you look at those trend lines, both of those have And the last one is where each one of those is compared to where they were in 2007. Just a note, under the Board of Elections, they have a negative 7 positions. That's because they gave up 10 part-time positions for 2 full-time positions. That's the only reason that one shows negative.
Pretty obvious that the Board of Commissioners took the biggest hit on static reductions. Fair to say.
Yes, sir.
The pie chart on the next page, where does your dollar go? This is for every dollar of property tax you pay. Where those go. And you see where the biggest portion of that. And these, I don't believe these changed at all from last year. And then on the last slide, we got this one in last year. This is the orange section is everyone besides the Board of Commissioners. And then the blue is the Board of Commissioners. So you are consistently 29% of your total expenditures.
Any questions for Stephanie? That will work.
Thank you, Stephanie. I made a name for you.
All right. Let's come back in about 15 minutes.